Hey everyone, this is Mike, and today I'm going to be doing a little update on closers, because today a very big patch came live. Didn't really bring any new content, but it did change a lot of the existing systems that are in the game, mostly pertaining to enhancement, and they also did a really big purification overhaul, and they also made it a lot easier to make Wolfgang and Hoffman trinkets. So let's take it one step at a time. Let's look at purification real quick first. So what they changed is they basically revamped the whole system of how you go through progressing through purification. Now, if you've already unlocked some of the stuff, you're basically gonna have to do it again, because for example, if I click on like the normal sides, you can see that I've only cleared the first two and that I've used all of my daily entries. So you'll have to clear this again. This doesn't take that long because one clear will advance you into the next stage. You also see a progress bar down here, which you can get some extra stuff with as well, but I'll talk about that in just a second. So basically, the way it works is still kind of the same. You've got your hell, which is always open the whole day around. As you can see, I can enter this once a day. You still need your entry tickets as well. And then, of course, you also have your chain. And then over here, we have, of course, overflow reverse, because today, Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday, overflow reverse is available. Then over here, this is your normal purification side sector. This is the normal purification sector. Today, for example, it's Tyndalos. And then we, of course, also have Nitocris. And then if you scroll down a little bit more, you can see that Yacht or overflow surface is not available today. Yacht is not available today. And then Harpas is not available today either. So you can kind of see what you can get. Now, as you can see over here as well, you can see that these bosses also drop trinkets as well as cores and modules. Now, the cool thing is that there is a chance for you to actually get one of those trinkets or a tier 3 core or mod when you clear these fights. So if you do overflow hell, there's a chance of you getting a hell trinket immediately or a tier 5 core. Thus, severely downsizing the amount of time that it requires you to get these things if you get lucky. When I did overflow today, I did not get lucky. For example, today's reverse. Reverse is used for the Nitocris shards, which gives you the tier 5 enhancement materials, like to get your receivers to tier 5. So for reverse, tier 5 shields can drop. So it's really cool that they implemented this into the game. This should make it so that purification is not something that you're going to be spending weeks of time on to get all of your stuff to tier 5 and to get those hell trinkets and that kind of stuff. So really cool stuff what they did here. Now, moving on to some very quick Hoffman stuff. So when we go to Transcendence, now you can craft these here now as well. But basically all of the, or you know what, I'll just move over to Hunter's Knight real quick. All of the Hoffman and Wolfgang stuff has become incredibly cheap. So cheap that I basically, when I was playing on my Levia earlier today, I went from having like only the base trinkets to having completely finished tier 5, or like tier 4 trinkets, I guess they are. So if I go to Sector Epic Gear, you can now also like craft the fully upgraded trinkets if you have enough materials. So that's really cool. But if you already have some like halfway done, for example, you can just go over here and, as you can see, incredibly cheap to buy all of these things. I do think it's cheaper to just like buy the fully upgraded trinket. But if you already have some spend, then you might as well just grab these. So yeah, upgrading these trinkets and just getting the trinkets is going to be a lot easier now as well. I'm not sure if the trinkets immediately drop from Wolfgang now, because I haven't done Wolfgang yet, because I'm only doing Hoffman at the moment. But basically, a whole lot cheaper, and should be a lot easier to grab those now as well. They're basically doing this so that people should be able to get ready for the new Beelzebub raid that is coming in 2 weeks. So, last but not least, we have Enhancement. So, as you can see, the Enhancement menu is completely different now. So, I got myself a plus 12 core over here. And I'll just show you real quick how the new enhancement system works. So you basically put it in here. As you can see, the only thing that can happen is failure. That means a minus one. So you can't reset. You can't lose your gear anymore. The only thing that can happen is minus one, nothing, or plus one, two, or three, depending on if you got success, big success, or great success. The only additive that they have now is the gear booster. This makes it so that minus one can't happen. So, for example, earlier today, I took my core, and as you can see, it's plus 15 now because I used my fortifiers. to basically make it so that I couldn't get those failures and then I only could get the plus one or more. So that's why I have that now. So basically, there's two different types of fuels. You've got your normal gear booster fuel. This can bring you up to plus 15, I believe. And then this one basically makes it so that you have a relatively great chance at success up to plus 13. And then you can still get great success at plus 13 as well, meaning that you can get up to plus 15. I'm not 100% sure where you can get these yet, because I haven't like been able to craft these yet. But I'm imagining that maybe the Beelzebub rate will drop these as well. So for example, I don't have my fortifier, so I'm gonna leave that empty. I've got my gear booster fuel. Here it will show what the stat increase is going to be. You can also press auto enhancement, then it will basically just keep going until you get a minus one or a plus one. This is really handy for if you're using fortifiers, so that you just like, for example, you put in 20 fortifiers, you put on auto enhancement, and it'll just keep going until you get that plus one or until you run out of fortifiers, I think. But basically, just press OK. There you go. No change. That's pretty much what it is. I'll just keep going a little bit more. We failed again. And then, of course, it can go to 9, because at plus 10 it can still fail. But as you can see, I'm not like just completely resetting the thing. I'm not losing the thing either, because it's not breaking. So yeah, it goes up to plus 10 guaranteed, and then from plus 10 onwards, it has, of course, a chance to fail. But I did my Soma mods earlier as well. It took me like, I think maybe 50 tries to get both of the mods from plus 12 to plus 13. So enhancement becomes so much easier. I'm not quite sure if you can actually craft these things. Yes, you can. So it does require reanimators to craft the gear booster fuels. But that's not too difficult to come by. You can get reanimators from a bunch of different places now. So you can just easily get those and then get those gear booster fuels. Now, one last thing I wanted to show with enhancement is that right now the gear boosters themselves are a little bit different as well. So before, you would have to like go to enhancement and then select a material here, which was your gear booster. But right now, the way it works is you just open the gear booster, you put in your gear, and then you just click OK. Of course, my thing is already plus 10. So there's no reason for me to do this, but that's basically how gear boosters work now. So if you want to enhance one of your things with a gear booster, you have to go and click on the gear booster itself. Stuff like lubricant, that's still exactly the same as it used to be. So that hasn't changed. So it's all enhancement that is different. Tuning is still the same as well. So if you want to tune this thing, it's still exactly the same as before. So yeah, that's pretty much the update to close this right now. We of course also got Levia's task force being released today. But this is pretty much it of the general content that they added or changed. So purification should be a lot easier to get now. I'll probably be doing it on a bunch of my alts now as well, because there's a lot of alts that I want to get purification gear on, but I didn't want to spend the weeks grinding to get it. So right now it should be a lot easier to get that. And then the Wolfgang trinkets and Hoffman trinkets are so much easier to get now as well. It shouldn't really take too much longer for you to be able to get those to get ready for when Beelzebub comes out. So that's going to be it for me. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one.